Students, today we'll discuss about another physics paper, JEE Mains Physics 2014. So let us discuss all those questions one by one. Okay. Hello students, let us move to question number 7. The question is 4 particles each of mass m and equidistant from each other move along a circle of radius r under the action of their mutual gravitational attraction. The speed of each particle is, now there is a circle like this, and here we have got 4 particles at equidistant. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are the 4 particles which are placed at equal distance from each other. Each particle is having mass m. And this is the center. Suppose this center is O. It has a radius r. So this is r. Radius is r. And they are moving in a circle under the action of their mutual gravitational force of attraction. That means this particle is moving because of the gravitational pull by this, this, and this. The resultant of all these 3 forces acting on the particle. Similarly, this particle is rotating because of the force of attraction by the 3 resultant of these 3 forces. So all the forces must be same. So speed of each particle, that means if you consider any particle, because the force acting on anyone is same, so I'll consider any one particle, suppose this particle, and see under what force this is moving in a circle. We know that for circular motion, centripetal force is needed. Okay. For and then who provides the centripetal force, and that centripetal force is needed, and that centripetal force is given by mv square divided by r. Now who provides the centripetal force? It is the net force towards the center that provides the centripetal force. That means this particle is subjected to 3 forces, because this mass will pull this along this line with a force which is equal to this force. Suppose I call this force is F1. This mass will pull this mass along this line with a force. I call this force as F2. And this mass will pull this mass along this line. This is also F2, because F2 means in terms of magnitude it is same, not in terms of direction. In terms of magnitude it is same, because the distance between these 2 particles and these 2 particles are same, and the masses are also same. So in terms of magnitude, the force F2 and this force F2 is same, and this force is different because the distance of separation between these 2 particles are different. Now to find the magnitude F2, so what is that force F2? This force F2 will be, the according to Newton's law of gravitation, g product of their masses, that is m square. Okay, I'm writing small m, but it is given capital M. No problem, you can replace that by capital M. G m square upon r square. R is this distance. Now how to find this distance? This distance and this distance is same. This distance is 2r, because it is the diameter, r plus r 2r. So 2r is square of this side, hypotenuse is square of this side and square of this side. Now these 2 sides are same, so a square plus a square, if I consider this side as a, this side is a, this side is a, this side is a, then this a square plus a square, 2a square is equal to the square of this side, that is 2r the whole square. So I will get here this side is a, this side is a, and this is 2r. So I have equations like a square plus a square equals to 2r the whole square. From here I get 2a square equals to 4r square. So from here a square is 2r square. A square is 2r square. So this f2 is gm square upon a square, and a square I got 2r square, so I'll put 2r square here. 2r square, this is the magnitude of this force, and this force is also same, and the angle is 90, and because these two forces are same, their component along this direction, because they'll bisect the toward the center, this force will be making an angle of 45 degree with this, and this also will make an angle of 45 with this. So in other case, we know that if the two forces are same, then and they make an angle of 90 degree, the resultant is a root 2 times the individual force. That means this force, combination of these two resultant forces, will be root 2 times this value. This value that also you can find by this method. You can see here. Now the situation is like this. This is mass over here, and this is F2. This angle is theta, that is 45. So I'll call this as F2 cos 45, and here also it is F2. So this angle is 45. So again, this component is also F2 cos 45. So these two forces, because the other component might be like this, its other component might be like that. They will cancel out each other. But then toward the center, the combination of these two forces, the contribution of these two forces is 2F2 cos 45, that is 2F2 is how much? F2 is gm square that we found last time, gm square upon 2R square, 2R square, and cos 45 is 1 upon root 2. So these two will cancel out. This is g m square upon root 2 r square. So the resultant of those two forces is in this direction, and now this we can directly also get, as I told you, it is root 2 times f2. Then root 2 times what is f2? F2 is g m square upon 2 r square. So it comes out to be gm square upon root 2 r square. The same thing you are getting here. So if you don't know this concept, that if we have a if you have two equal forces acting at an angle, suppose this is a, this is a, if they have an angle of 90 degree, then the resultant will be root 2 times any one of the forces. If you know this, you will save your time. Otherwise we can calculate by taking the components, and which comes out to be this. Now we got the resultant of this two toward this, which comes out to be this value. Again, we have to find another force F1 that is acting because of this mass. Because of this mass, the force will be, that is F1. So for then we'll calculate F1 also. So let us find F1. F1, for F1 the situation is, this mass is here, the other mass is there, the distance between them, this is the center, and so distance is r plus r, and this 2r, the distance is 2r. So therefore the force will act along the line, because it is a central force. So therefore the force will be g product of their masses square, now divided by r square. R square is 2r square is 4r square. Okay, now what happens is, we have got total forces. This is the force F1, and we have got another two forces So then earlier we found the resultant of two F2 forces, F2, F2, and that comes out to be what we got last time, g m square upon root 2 r square. So this is a force which is resultant of two F2 forces, F2 resultant. So this and this is this value. Now these two are in the same direction, you add up. So the net force towards the center responsible for circular motion is given by G m square upon 4 r square plus G m square upon root 2 r square. So this is a net force toward the center. This unbalanced net force toward the center provides centripetal force. This is providing centripetal force. So what we'll have, that centripetal force mv square by r acting on the any one particle is equal to the net force that we calculated here, g m square divided by 4 r square plus g m square divided by root 2 r square. Now our aim is to find the speed of each particle. That means we are looking for v, looking for this v. Then we can take m, 1 m cancel out, 1 m remains, 1 r cancel out, 1 r will remain. Now this v square comes out to be gm, if I take common, or otherwise gm upon r I take common from these two, this is 1 by 4 plus 1 by root 2. So from here v comes out to be under root of gm upon r 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon root of 2. Now now if I see the options, this is the answer, but then the answer is not matching with any other option. So you have to convert this into the this type of form. That means gm upon r, and there is no denominator, so for simplify that and take whatever common is possible out of the root. So let us do that. Now this is under root gm upon r, this 4 root 2, I will take 4 root 2 here, LCM, and this will be root 2 and this will be 4. Okay. Now this 4 comes out of the root and becomes half under root of gm upon r, okay, bracket. Then this 4 goes out, this is root 2 plus 4 by root 2. Root 2 plus 4 by root 2. Just see here, root 2 plus 4 by root 2 will be left because 4 goes out as 2 and there is no more 4 here. So this expression will be like this. If you separate that, it is 1 plus 4 by root 2 or root 2 over this. Okay. Now this is root 2 plus 4. So I'll write 1 plus, from here you can see 1 plus 4 by root 2. Again, it is not matching. You can see here half comes out is okay. Gm upon r, this is you have to balance. Now 4 by root 2 can be written as 2 into root 2 into root 2 divided by root 2. This root 2, this root 2 will cancel. So it is 2 root 2. So that means this will be, this finally comes out to be v equals to half under root of gm by r bracket 1 plus, this solves to give you 2 root 2. 2 root 2. This is the final expression. Now, if I look at the option now, you can see here 1 by 2 under root of gm upon r 1 plus 2 root 2. So, therefore, this option number 4 is the correct answer to this question. Okay, thank you.